This video is all about the soothing cacao ingredient in Pokemon Sleep, and throughout the video we will comprehensively list every single ingredient specialist, berry specialist, and skill specialist that have the soothing cacao as an ingredient option. The soothing cacao has a pretty high value of 151, and it's not a rare ingredient. You can find it in the level 1 spot for quite a few Pokemon. So, an honorable mention here right at the start is the Nightcap Pikachu. Depending on the level here, it has a max level of 18, so look away from the 30 here. The Nightcap Pikachu will farm Grapa Berries, which is the electric type berry, and it will also drop you apples and cacao. The frequency and the inventory and the number of these depend on the level, but we're just going to use the max level here as an example. So over time you will get a decent amount of cacao and apples, so it's a nice supplement, but overall it's not enough to really cook any sizable dishes or anything like that. So just to have mentioned it, the Nightcap Pikachu is pretty good. So Blastoise, these are the two main cacao ingredient specialists that we will be covering in this video, and we will also go a little bit over what kind of sub skills and some of the natures that can be good on these two Pokemon. The good part of the strategy for dessert week is covering the cacao and the milk and the honey and the eggs. What's pretty cool with the Blastoise is it has access to the milks and the cacaos, and those are both really good for dessert week. Same thing here with the Absol. It is the only Pokemon with triple cacao as an ingredient specialist, and it also has access to the apples, which is a big ingredient during dessert week as well. So both of these Pokemon are really good for dessert week. If you, for example, get your hands on a double milk cacao Blastoise, that can be really strong. And overall, Blastoise is a really good Pokemon. I would probably place it in high A tier, and during dessert week it's just going to be really strong for you. So definitely one of the Pokemon that can be very useful to level up even past 60, so that you can make use of these three ingredient slots that do really work nicely together. The ingredient rate on the Blastoise is incredibly strong. 27% is one of the highest in the game, and the frequency here is not bad at all. The inventory is decent as well. Catch it as a Squirtle, and then upon evolution you will gain another 5 to the inventory here per evolution, so 27 in total. The ingredient magnet here is not too much of a boost overall. 2% is quite low, but you will find some tails over time, and if you happen to find like a skill level up M placed in an awkward spot, but the Blastoise overall is really nice, then that level 5 main skill level here is going to be a nice boost. The Absol is the main cacao Pokemon. Overall, the Absol is quite difficult to find, and it is hard to befriend, and then once you find it and you befriend it, it has a low ingredient rate. So you will be looking for the ingredient finder M for sure on the Absol, and you do want the ingredient finding nature as well. And then on top of that, it's not particularly fast, so you will be interested in the helping speed as well. And it has a low inventory, it doesn't evolve, so you will want the inventory as well. Absol is a hard Pokemon, which means it could be a good idea to potentially run double Blastoise, where you have milk, milk, and then whatever else, and then milk, cacao, so that you get a good blend, potentially just a double set of Blastoise that you cap at level 30, where you have milk, cacao as the pattern. And then because of this high ingredient drop rate, you're not too worried. You're not too worried about it. And then the inventory is pretty good as well. The big problem with Absol is if you go the cacao apple route, you're gonna have a big, big problem with the inventory here and the ingredient rate. And then you probably won't have space for the speed. So we'll cover this in the expansion here a little bit, and then we'll go back to looking at all the other Pokemon that do find cacao. The interesting thing with cacao is it is on so many Pokemon that you can, to a large extent, rely on the skill specialist for this ingredient. So that is interesting compared to a lot of the other ingredient deep dive videos that I've put together so far. If you manage, though, and these are from a previous video, So if you manage to find a triple cacao Absol, that is pretty strong. And so we're going to use that as an example here. We're going to put the ingredient finder M and just the inventory M, let's say. The speed is not a big detriment, just because if you do manage to find the triple cacao, whenever you do need cacao, Absol is going to bring a lot of it once it drops. And yeah, the 17% here is equivalent to the Gengar. I think part of it is this high value on the ingredient, as well as the total number of the drop here, which is pretty big. But that means you definitely want the ingredient finder M on the Absol, and you definitely, for sure, even more so, want the inventory, particularly if you end up getting the apple here in the last spot, and if you do plan on racing the Absol past level 30. When it comes to the nature, I have made a video detailing just all the sub-skills and the natures that are really useful on ingredient specialist Pokemon, and I've placed it in the Pokemon Sleep for Beginners playlist. You can check that out in the video description if you're interested, and then we'll just quickly cover two of the best natures here and not really go too much in a deep dive. The mild nature is very strong on the Absol. Energy recovery is not too big a problem if you do have a healer, which most people do run, at the very least by the time they are able to hunt the Absol. And then we have the rash nature. Particularly on Absol, you really, really don't care about the main skill. It doesn't evolve, and this value is negligible. So the main skill chance here, you don't care about, even if it has 3.7% here. And yeah, so overall, I would say the Absol is a very difficult Pokemon to obtain, and it is even harder to get the exact sub-skills and nature that you want. So I could potentially recommend you to go for the cacao-cacao-apple combo, or the cacao-cacao-cacao, just full-on mono. Another potential for the Absol could be the double apple. One problem with that is the inventory. So if you, for example, find like inventory L as well on the Absol, that could potentially be it. But we always have to keep in mind this low ingredient rate. So for sure, you will want the ingredient finder M here. Otherwise, you'll be quite upset about finding a lot of berries instead of the ingredients. One thing to mention as well when it comes to the berries, for a lot of Pokemon that has the ingredients as their specialty, but they have a low ingredient drop rate, it is often a good idea to consider the berry finding. Absol is not one of those Pokemon, in my opinion. The reason is the extremely low inventory, on top of the fact that it doesn't evolve. So if you do find the berry finding here on the Absol, in my opinion, it's going to be a bigger hindrance than anything. So past level 10 friendship, if you do hunt for the Absol on the long run, then I personally wouldn't like the berry finding. It could potentially stack nicely on Snowdrop, but it is slow. You're mostly looking for the ingredients and then going back to your berry specialist. So I wouldn't recommend berry finding personally. And overall, if you can just secure a little bit of extra inventory, that's going to give you a lot of punch and power on the Absol. And overall, something like this. Don't have too high expectations. and just try to either go for the apple double, no, the cacao, double apple, the double cacao, or the triple cacao. I don't recommend the mushroom, and the reason is it is not useful during dessert week, except a filler. So we can have a quick look at the mushroom as well. It's got a big value, but don't want the mushrooms on your absol. Okay, so let's go back to the overall list here. We have covered Blastoise a little bit. Probably we'll use some time to cover the basic topics, but eventually I will make a how to use Blastoise video that you can look forward to, and we'll go really in depth on all the options. There is an honorable mention here at the end too when it comes to ingredients, but overall I don't recommend it. This is the final ingredient specialist that do carry the cacao, and it is Delibird. Delibird has eggs in its first spot, and then apples, and then cacao. So potentially if you find a really, really good Delibird in terms of the nature and the sub skills and everything aligns, I think potentially Delibird is one of those rare instances where you can go with either one of these ingredient lists. It's kind of crazy that way. So the ultimate Delibird, of course, would be to find the triple egg, because it is the only triple egg, and that makes it particularly strong. But eggs and apples and cacao are all really important ingredients during dessert week. So mostly you can't really hit wrong with a Delibird, except if you really get some poor natures and if you don't get the ingredient finder app. You can see here 18%, not particularly strong. So you definitely want a boost to the ingredient finding rate. And inventory is decent. It's a little bit better than the Absol. And also when you consider the drop rates here, 12 apples on the Absol is completely crazy. And especially with that low inventory. So yeah, Delibird is one to consider. Personally, I would either go a double egg apple or egg, apple, egg, or triple egg on the Delibird. I'm not too fan of the cacao on the Delibird just because the apple egg combo is so strong. And you could have a Blastoise for cacao. So then we've covered every single ingredient specialist that do get the cacao as one of their ingredients. And we can start on the long list. I think for the most part, this will have to be a little bit of a rapid fire, just left, right on the on the widget here. So we do have the Wigglytuff. For the most part, these will be in the last slot. So with the Pokemon also having a specialty to consider, you don't really want to aim for a good ingredient list. And same with the berries. You don't really care too much about the ingredients and actually want that ingredient finding down nature. So, but these are Pokemon to consider. Some of these do provide quite a bit of support cacao, which is surprising. So we can just go over them. We have the Wigglytuff, and then we have the Golduck. Golduck does carry the potential for triple cacao. That is nice. It also has the apples, which is very nice in combo. So for example, if you go cacao, apple, cacao, then on the Golduck, that could potentially be worthwhile to hunt for that somewhat dual specialist. It has a very low ingredient rate though, so don't be too big on these ingredient preferences, because it is a skill specialist and it is the skills you're the most interested in. But if you somehow find a good set of sub skills and a good nature, and you also happen to find a good ingredient list, you don't want the sausage, then that could be a pretty decent Golduck. Then we have the Dodrio. And it has double cacao potential. It is a berry specialist, so don't put too much thought into the ingredient list. Same with the Marowak. It does have a decent cacao drop. As you can see, the difference in numbers here is 2 in the second slot and 3 in the third. And ginger is a pretty nice ingredient. So overall, Marowak looking good. And then we have all the evolutions. Now, I'm not going to go through every single evolution because they have the same ingredient potential. I would say mostly on the evolutions, the milks can be quite useful. And obviously the cacaos as well. The bean is, or the bean sausage is not particularly strong, but for the most part, you're not optimizing for the ingredient list on a skill specialist, particularly not an important skill specialist such as the Eevee and the Eeveelutions. A lot of those are S tier, A tier Pokemon, and at that point, you really don't care about the ingredient list. It's all about the skills. And then we can jump over to an interesting Pokemon here that I have covered in a couple videos by now, and that is the Meganium. Meganium has an interesting combo here with cacao and honey, which is great for dessert week. The ingredient rate here is low, and as a berry specialist, you want to make it even lower with that nature and none of the ingredient finding subskills. So there is something to consider here, but for the most part, especially on the Meganium, it's a very strong berry specialist at Lapis Lakeside, so it's just one of those nice things to have if you are able to find a good subskill Meganium that also has the decent ingredients. And then we have the Slowpoke line. We have Slowking and Slowbro. I'm just going to cover one of these. Obviously, on this evolution line, you definitely do not want the cacao, you don't want the tomato, you want the double tail. You do get one cacao in the first spot, but you always, always, always want the double tails on the Slowking. The main skill here is decent. It is a skill specialist, so for the most part, you do want to amplify the main skill as much as possible, but not to the detriment of these tails, in my opinion. That's a little bit of an exception just because how rare and valuable the Slowpoke tails are, and overall how little useful the Slowking is with the energy here compared to, for example, the Gardevoir. Okay, and then we have Sableye. Sableye is a potentially an F tier Pokemon. I don't like it. It's very poor. It does have cacao in the last slot as an option. Don't recommend the Sableye. Togekiss has also got the cacao in the last slot. And then at the very end, we have Dedenne. Dedenne is an interesting Pokemon as well. It has a cooking centered main skill, and it has a decent amount of dessert ingredients. If I'm not mistaken, corn is interesting in all of the different dish types, but for the most part, you probably want like double cacao or triple apple. And at that point, you'd be very happy with that. So we've now covered every single berry specialist, ingredient specialist, and skill specialist. And in future videos, now that we have been a lot more familiar with the various Pokemon, we can start piecing together some cooking videos, and those will be very interesting. So hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did. And yeah, I'll see you around. Thank you for watching.